Welcome once again, audience. I have 10 logos prepared and ready. This is a follow-up video from the part one of animating logos, where I just talked about what my feelings are about the logos. This is actually me showing you what the animations I made for those logos are, and expressing those feelings I had into actual movement and animation. So enjoy. This is going to be a shorter video. Hope you enjoy it. Please excuse all of the random YouTube edit techniques, which is just to shorten the amount of time I'm on screen and shorten the amount of time filling up your day. So enjoy. Let's take it away, shall we? And we are recording whatever I guess is on screen now, because it's Windows and there's a lot of liability, I'm told. But yeah, we have our project here with all our assets, all of the clips. So I usually animate in After Effects, and then I do all of the finishing and exporting in Premiere. It's just a bit more streamlined for audio and video syncing and making it feel like it's a good thing that you're watching. Yeah, so you can see at the bottom here where my mouse is, if you can see that, all of the sequences for every product. We'll be starting on this one. Just being organized is a good thing when you are editing. It's a very good thing to make folders for yourself, make your life easier, and other people who have to look at what you just did if you're working in a bigger company. So let's start off. Let's just go through. We don't really need all of the controls right now. I've done most of the editing. Please ignore my very bad layout of Premiere. It's my own making. That's the fun of Adobe. You can mix and match however you want these days, and I guess every other program has followed suit. This is Apple. Let's just get very professional here, because we don't want to disrespect any of these companies because of money reasons. Yeah, so this is Apple. I had the idea of making a click because they're a technology company, and yeah, so enjoy. I think it came out pretty well. The sound you might recognize is from Netflix. It's the reverse of that intro, and I just wanted to build up to that ultimate click sound. Yeah, so it can just be a bit more impactful. And yeah, this is their white, and I just like how it came out. And there is a slight motion blur going on that eye. Ugh, the dot on their apple, not their eye. So imagine that being a crisp, crystalline sound to pervade the class and the professionalism of Mercedes and everything they do. So I did a very basic one here, no real sounds yet. But yeah, I think it looks good. It feels nice and smooth, and it just drops down like a fountain. Like their abundance, and they're always ready to serve, and they're generous. I like those terminologies with things. This is my attempt at playing homage to the brand. Yeah, that was it. Hope you like it. Yeah, and I don't think it went to come out too well. Obviously, people with more expertise in the marketing divisions would have their own nitty-gritty comments about these things, but this is just for a YouTube video, so. I know it's a bit more subtle. There's a lot of work that went into that. I like that at a certain point, it kind of almost exactly lines up with that E, even though the E is very small in this logo. I like it. And I like the fact that when the logo does come in, it's its own liquid and then settles on the final liquid form. So yeah, I thought subtlety would be better because it's about the frivolity of the brand and the playfulness and the light airedness, and that's why I like the sound of the bubbles, because why not have happy bubbles? I like the way that renders. I really like the way this turned out. It's just a whole, there's just so much going on and so much eye candy. It's called, according to me, the Blade Runner effect, where there's just so much happening on screen and so much that's titillating your senses, which I do appreciate when a film does that correctly. Yeah, it's just, there's just so much in fashion that wants you to have that feeling, to make you buy clothes. So obviously it's about senses, and it's Chanel, and it's about perfume and handbags. So yeah, I really like this. So there are a few things happening there, and you might not have noticed it. It might be a little too fast for the eye. Okay, so the actual logo sort of impacts when that hip happens, and then it grows like a very organic way of animating a logo. A very time-consuming way of animating a logo. See, I like it. It has, once you're aware that it's an impact of something, you obviously see a lot more happening. Next logo. Very straightforward. Usually with their ads, if they ever have ads, they're very straightforward about associating positivity with the brand, and they don't need to do very much. It's a very reliable service, so they don't need to impress very much. And I thought everything speaks for itself, so it's pretty cool. It's very elegant, very simple, straightforward, to the point. And I guess that's about what deliveries need to be reliable and have a good reputation. I get, for some reason, I'm getting a very SpongeBob feel about this, which is good because it's associated with the sea. Aye aye, kids. I can't hear you. Type of vibe. I'm a bit iffy about the Starbucks logo, but yeah, I could have done better. I could have made the wobble a little less pronounced, and made a bit more effort with what a soundscape could be added with it. That is another tip. There should be some type of way to hear what you're doing without actually having sound. So it's great for these types of exercises if you can hear something in your head already while this is playing, instead of anything related to SpongeBob. You will have known you animated it correctly for the taste of ad and the type of ad and the mood of the ad you want to convey. So yeah, quick tip. Yeah, tell me if you want more tutorials like these. Yeah, I like anything 2D, you're trying to sell the idea of there being more than two dimensions. But yeah, it happens so quick, you don't really realize what types of effects are used in After Effects. And it just sells that this is being written out more easily, and the bottom and the top flourishes were animated by hand, by keyframe and masking. And the top C flourishes two elements, which goes behind the eye, and then with another element that grows in front of the eye. And as soon as that element comes in, the section that of the L it goes in front of pops out to make it look more like they're like it actually got went through that thing. So there's three dimensions to that just circle with the C coming through that. Yeah, I'm really happy how all of these turned out. I'm proud of all of them. Maybe not the Starbucks one, but yeah, you can always do better with anything related to art and media. There's always room for improvement. If you're at the end of this video, well done. I do appreciate that. Tell me what you would like to see in future relating to these things. After Effects, if you want more After Effects tutorials, I'd really like to know what you think. Leave a comment, like and subscribe. Subscribe, please. Yeah, and have a lovely day. The world is in the turmoil because of people having different colors and different color eyes, apparently. It's a big epidemic. Like the whole virus and people's eyes, what they see in the world, it's changing everything. So I'm glad I can just make this content for you. Just focus on something else for a bit, and yeah. See you next time.